DNA ligase. DNA ligase is a specific type of enzyme, a ligase, that facilitates the joining of DNA strands together by catalyzing the formation of a phosphodiester bond. It plays a role in repairing single-strand breaks in duplex DNA in living organisms, but some forms, such as DNA ligase 4, may specifically repair double-strand breaks, i.e. a break in both complementary strands of DNA. Single-strand breaks are repaired by DNA ligase using the complementary strand of the double helix as a template, with DNA ligase creating the final phosphodiester bond to fully repair the DNA. DNA ligase is used in both DNA repair and DNA replication, see mammalian ligases. In addition, DNA ligase has extensive use in molecular biology laboratories for recombinant DNA experiments, see research applications. Purified DNA ligase is used in gene cloning to join DNA molecules together to form recombinant DNA. The mechanism of DNA ligase is to form two covalent phosphodiester bonds between three hydroxyl ends of one nucleotide, acceptor, with the 5-phosphatened of another, donor. Two ATP molecules are consumed for each phosphodiester bond formed. AMP is required for the ligase reaction, which proceeds in 4 steps. Ligase will also work with blunt ends, although higher enzyme concentrations and different reaction conditions are required. The E. coli DNA ligase is encoded by the lig gene. DNA ligase in E. coli, as well as most prokaryotes, uses energy gained by cleaving nicotinamide adenine adenucleotide, NAD, to create the phosphodiester bond. It does not ligate blunt end of DNA except under conditions of molecular crowding with polyethylene glycol, and cannot join RNA to DNA efficiently. The activity of E. coli DNA ligase can be enhanced by DNA polymerase at the right concentrations. Enhancement only works when the concentrations of DNA polymerase 1 are much lower than the DNA fragments to be ligated. When the concentrations of poly DNA polymerases are higher, it has an adverse effect on E. coli DNA ligase. The DNA ligase from bacteriophage T4 enter a bacteriophage T4 is a bacteriophage that infects Escherichia coli bacteria. The T4 phage is a member of the T-even phages, a group including enterobacteriophages T2 and T6. T4 is capable of undergoing only a lytic life cycle and not lysogenic life cycle, is the ligase most commonly used in laboratory research. It can ligate either cohesive or blunt ends of DNA, oligonucleotides, as well as RNA and RNA-DNA hybrids, but not single-stranded nucleic acids. It can also ligate blunt end of DNA with much greater efficiency than E. coli DNA ligase. Unlike E. coli DNA ligase, T4 DNA ligase cannot utilize NAD and it has an absolute requirement for ATP as a cofactor. Some engineering has been done to improve the in vitro activity of T4 DNA ligase. One successful approach, for example, tested T4 DNA ligase fused to several alternative DNA binding proteins and found that the constructs with either P50 or NFKB as fusion partners were over 160% more active in blunt-end ligagens for cloning purposes than wild-type T4 DNA ligase. A typical reaction for inserting a fragment into a plasmid vector would use about 0.01, sticky ends, to 1, blunt ends, units of ligase. The optimal incubation temperature for T4 DNA ligase is 16 degrees Celsius. In mammals, there are 4 specific types of ligase. DNA ligase from eukaryotes and some microbes uses adenosine triphosphate, ATP, rather than NAD. Derived from a thermophilic bacterium, the enzyme is stable and active at much higher temperatures than conventional DNA ligases. Its half-life is 48 hours at 65 degrees Celsius and greater than 1 hour at 95 degrees Celsius. Ampligase DNA ligase has been shown to be active for at least 500 thermal cycles, 94 degrees Celsius/80 degrees Celsius or 16 hours of cycling. This exceptional thermostability permits extremely high hybridization stringency and ligation specificity. There are at least 3 different units used to measure the activity of DNA ligase. DNA ligases have become indispensable tools in modern molecular biology research for generating recombinant DNA sequences. For example, DNA ligases are used with restriction enzymes to insert DNA fragments, often genes, into plasmids. Controlling the optimal temperature is a vital aspect of performing efficient recombination experiments involving the ligation of cohesive-ended fragments. Most experiments use T4 DNA ligase, isolated from bacteriophage T4, which is most active at 37 degrees Celsius. However, for optimal ligation efficiency with cohesive and dead fragments, sticky ends, the optimal enzyme temperature needs to be balanced with the melting temperature T of the sticky ends being ligated. The homologous pairing of the sticky ends will not be stable because the high temperature disrupts hydrogen bonding. A ligation reaction is most efficient when the sticky ends are already stably annealed, and disruption of the annealing ends would therefore result in low ligation efficiency. The shorter the overhang, the lower the T. It has been shown recently that T4 DNA ligase in combination with 3M betaine and 10% PEG-8000 can ligate XNA molecules. Since blunt-ended DNA fragments have no cohesive ends to anneal, the melting temperature is not a factor to consider within the normal temperature range of the ligation reaction. The limiting factor in blunt-end ligation is not the activity of the ligase but rather the number of alignments between DNA fragment ends that occur. The most efficient ligation temperature for blunt-ended DNA would therefore be the temperature at which the greatest number of alignments can occur. The majority of blunt-ended ligations are carried out at 14 to 25 degrees Celsius overnight. The absence of stably annealed ends also means that the ligation efficiency is lowered, requiring a higher ligase concentration to be used. A novel use of DNA ligase can be seen in the field of nanochemistry, specifically in DNA origami. DNA-based self-assembly principles have proven useful for organizing nanoscale objects, such as biomolecules, nanomachines, nanoelectronic and photonic component. Assembly of such nanostructure requires the creation of an intricate mesh of DNA molecules. Although DNA self-assembly is possible without any outside help using different substrates such as provision of catatonic surface of aluminium foil, DNA ligase can provide the enzymatic assistance that is required to make DNA lattice structure from DNA overhangs. The first DNA ligase was purified and characterized in 1967 by the Gellert, Lehmann, Richardson, and Hurwitz laboratories. It was first purified and characterized by Weiss and Richardson using a six-step chromatographic fractionation process beginning with elimination of cell debris and addition of streptomycin, followed by several diethylaminoethyl, DEAE cellulose column washes and a final phosphocellulose fractionation. The final extract contained 10% of the activity initially recorded in the E. coli media. Along the process it was discovered that ATP and Mg++ were necessary to optimize the reaction. The common commercially available DNA ligases were originally discovered in bacteriophage T4, E. coli and other bacteria. Genetic deficiencies in human DNA ligases have been associated with clinical syndromes marked by immunodeficiency, radiation sensitivity, and developmental abnormalities. Lig4 syndrome, ligase-4 syndrome, is a rare disease associated with mutations in DNA ligase-4 and interferes with SNP break repair mechanisms. Ligase-4 syndrome causes immunodeficiency in individuals and is commonly associated with microcephaly and marrow hypoplasia. A list of prevalent diseases caused by lack of or malfunctioning of DNA ligase is as follows. Xeroderma pigmentosum, which is commonly known as XP, is an inherited condition characterized by an extreme sensitivity to ultraviolet, UV, rays from sunlight. This condition mostly affects the eyes and areas of skin exposed to the sun. Some affected individuals also have problems involving the nervous system. Mutations in the ATM gene cause ataxia telangiectasia. The ATM gene provides instructions for making a protein that helps control cell division and is involved in DNA repair. This protein plays an important role in the normal development and activity of several body systems, including the nervous system and immune system. The ATM protein assists cells in recognizing damaged or broken DNA strands and coordinates DNA repair by activating enzymes that fix the broken strands. Efficient repair of damaged DNA strands helps maintain the stability of the cell's genetic information. Affected children typically develop difficulty walking, problems with balance and hand coordination, involuntary jerking movements, chorea, muscle twitches, myoclonus, and disturbances in nerve function, neuropathy. The movement problems typically cause people to require wheelchair assistance by adolescence. People with this disorder also have slurred speech and trouble moving their eyes to look side to side, oculomotor apraxia. Fanconi anemia, FA, is a rare, inherited blood disorder that leads to bone marrow failure. FA prevents bone marrow from making enough new blood cells for the body to work normally. FA also can cause the bone marrow to make many faulty blood cells. This can lead to serious health problems, such as leukemia. Bloom syndrome results in skin that is sensitive to sun exposure, and usually the development of a butterfly-shaped patch of reddened skin across the nose and cheeks. A skin rash can also appear on other areas that are typically exposed to the sun, such as the back of the hands and the forearms. Small clusters of enlarged blood vessels, telangiectasias, often appear in the rash. Telangiectasias can also occur in the eyes. Other skin features include patches of skin that are lighter or darker than the surrounding areas, hypopigmentation or hyperpigmentation respectively. These patches appear on areas of the skin that are not exposed to the sun, and their development is not related to the rashes. In recent studies, human DNA ligase was used in computer-aided drug design to identify DNA ligase inhibitors as possible therapeutic agents to treat cancer. Since excessive cell growth is a hallmark of cancer development, targets chemotherapy that disrupts the functioning of DNA ligase can impede adjuvant cancer forms. Furthermore, it has been shown that DNA ligase can be broadly divided into two categories, namely ATP-dependent and NAD+-dependent. Previous research has shown that although NAD-dependent DNA ligases have been discovered in sporadic cellular or viral niches outside the bacterial domain of life, there is no instance in which a NAD-dependent ligase is present in a eukaryotic organism. The narrow phylogenetic distribution, unique substrate specificity, and distinctive domain structure of NAD+-dependent compared with ATP-dependent human DNA ligases recommend the NAD ligases as targets for the development of new antibacterial drugs. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.